Yeah, Mom, why don't you say that? Just put that I had a college interview and that I got stuck in the storm. That's all you have to say.
Just the thought of you out there without any protection from that snow or Jagger makes me crazy.
We were fine, Mom.
I was worried absolutely sick. It's a good thing that I had Jason to kind of calm me down. He's so wonderful, honey. You're so lucky to have him. There you go. So, how are things going between you and Jason?
Okay.
Just okay?
What do you want me to say?
How about Mom? We're engaged. Is there something wrong, honey? I can feel these things. You know, a mother knows these things.
Mom, Jason and I just got too serious too soon.
Oh, honey, you're not breaking up with Jason, are you? Did something happen in that snowstorm?
No, what do you mean?
Did something happen with that bum Jagger?
Mom, I told you that we stayed with the family. Nothing happened.
Please don't tell me you're starting to fall for him.
Would you just quit giving me the third degree?
I can't believe this after all you and I talked about.
You were just jumping to conclusions.
I can't believe that you would pick a lowlife like Jagger over Jason.
Don't you say that about him. You know nothing about him.
I know everything there is to know about Jagger, Kate. I know that he's got a criminal record. I know that he works in a diner. And I know that he's penniless.
Do you know what kind of person he is? Huh?
Yes, I do know what kind of person he is. I've been with a dozen Jaggers in my life. They've got nothing to offer but good hair. They've got no education, they've got no dreams, and they've got no morals. And a few years later, the hair's gone too. And if they're still around, you'll be stuck with absolutely nothing.
You know what? You just want me to pay for all your mistakes.
No. I want you to learn from them. All right, there's no percentage in repeating them. A quartermain does not walk into everyone's life, and it's not going to happen again to you, honey.
This isn't about a quartermain. This is about Jason and me and whether we have a future together.
And you think that you have this future with Jagger? Look at me, honey. I'm alone. Where's my Jagger, for God's sake? Where's Jason now? Hi, honey. Come
on in. Hi, Mrs. Wexler.
Hi. Hi, Rhonda, please.
You look great.
Thank you.
Well, you forgot to tell me last night. How'd the interview go?
Well, I think it went well. Dean seemed to like me anyway.
That's great. That's great. I'm looking at a college girl.
Hang on. I haven't been accepted yet.
No sweat. You're going to have your pick of campuses. Karen's going places, Rhonda.
I know. Now all she has to do is make the right decision.
Last time I saw you, I said, cut one more class and you're out. Do you recall that?
But
yesterday came and you didn't. Goodbye, Jagger. You're gone. Expelled. How do you say history?
No, wait a minute. He's got an excuse.
Miss Wexler, your opinion is not needed in this matter.
Well, he took me to my college interview when Jason couldn't come. He did me a favor, Mr. Gordon. We had no idea we were going to get stuck in the snow. I think he deserves another chance.
You are jeopardizing your educational future. It hardly seems worth it.
Just hear me out, please.
I don't want to discuss this here. Both of you. Follow me to my office.
I was close, huh?
Yeah, you did good.
I'm afraid of Mr. Gordon. He gets so fed up with his attitude towards all the students. He's so full of himself, you know.
He likes you.
He's just impressed with my grades.
No, it's not the grades. Just he knew he was dealing with an equal.
Thank you. It's a really nice thing to say.
Well, I'm a nice guy.
I'll buy that.
I miss you so much. And I just didn't want to leave, you know?
I know. Me neither.
Did you tell Jason?
Well, I was going to tell him this morning, but, he was just being so sweet and everything. I just couldn't get it out. I'm going to tell him, I promise. I will.
Well, I'm going to tell Brenda today. I mean, it's hard. It's going to be hard for her to go back to live with her sister.
I will tell Jason tonight, okay? I will.
I think about you.
Just be patient, please. Because this isn't going to be easy.
Patient is my real name. Just...
Hey, here's my guy.
Hi.
Hi. So, what happened? You guys get suspended?
We're still here. What'd you do, bat your baby blues and get out of it? Works every time. I'm late for my hotline duty, so I better go. Don't let us stop you.
I won't.
See you guys. Bye, Robin.
Hey, wait up, Karen. You gotta tell me what happened.
So, hey, that's really great news.
Mm-hmm.
Why don't we go find an empty classroom and celebrate?
How about we take a walk in the park? I want to talk to you.
Okay.
Hey.
Oh, look, there's swings. Let's go swing on them.
Let's just sit for a second, please.
All right. So cool.
Yeah.
Wouldn't it be nice if we had a fireplace in our room?
Brenda, let's talk.
Okay. Talk. You haven't said three words since we've been out here.
Remember, they told me that after the holidays, you're going to find your own place?
Yeah. It's just the money. I mean, I don't know if I can do it by myself. It's expensive.
But what if I loan you some? And you can take all the time you want and you need to pay me back.
You bribing me?
No, Brenda, it's just I am used to living alone.
Jagger, look, what is it? Am I too messy? I can clean up more,
It's not that.
You just don't want me around?
Brenda, we have a good time together, okay? But I don't want a roommate. I never did.
If I move out, then we'll never see each other. We'll hardly see each other.
I know. Brenda, things happen too fast.
How long have you been feeling this way, Jagger?
Honestly, since you moved in.
I thought things were okay between us.
Things did happen between us, and I had a great time. But right now in my life, I need to be alone again. I know, Brenda, you can do it. I know you can.
Look, I'll have my stuff out by tomorrow, okay? I just need one more day.